After the Battle of Lexington and Concord, realizing she had a full-scale rebellion on her hands, Britain sent an additional 25,000 troops to the colonies. The American response was equally passionate. Men from all over the colonies signed up for 90-day enlistments. The Revolutionary War was about to begin in earnest.
After the battles at Lexington and Concord, two events moved the Revolution swiftly forward. Militia from other New England colonies poured into Massachusetts and surrounded Boston, trapping the British army there. And delegates from the colonies met in a Second Continental Congress at Philadelphia. The Congress now had to form a government and conduct a war. The siege of Boston precipitated the Battle of Bunker Hill, the first large-scale action with colonial soldiers fighting British regulars. American forces were woefully undersupplied, and lines of command were muddled, causing great chaos.
Dear Mr. Samuel Adams, to be plain, it appears to me there was never more confusion and less command.
The British assaulted the American lines. American commanders, knowing they had to hoard their powder and shot, ordered their men to be patient.
Hold your fire, men, until you see the whites of their eyes.
Twice the British regulars were repulsed with heavy losses. On the third try, they breached the American defenses largely because the militias had run out of ammunition and discipline had broken down. Oddly, the lack of military discipline and training did allow the Americans some measure of victory. Improvisation and novel solutions gave the Yankees an ability to fight and then run away to fight another day. But the Battle of Bunker Hill demonstrated the urgency of a trained army to the new government. Congress immediately issued paper money to pay the troops, appointed delegates to negotiate with foreign countries for military aid, and sought a commander-in-chief of a Continental Army. They chose George Washington. Made a colonel after his own heroics in the Battle of Wilderness in 1755, Washington was the colony's only true military leader. Washington's passive engagement in Virginia politics, his own balanced personality, and the loyalty and admiration of those men whom he commanded in the French and Indian War made him the logical choice to lead America's army. Washington quickly took command of the militias in Massachusetts and began training them into an effective fighting force. His appointment as commander-in-chief proved to be the most important decision in America's revolution.